So I'm going to do a mechanism which draws hyperbola not by defining a set of points on the hyperbola, but by defining a set of lines which are tangent to the hyperbola. The one I'm going to do is that figure there, 212. We'll just be doing one of the tangents. The figure actually gives you two right angle tangents, but we'll just do one. So what we have here, we're going to be establishing a point, a fixed point here that a line is going to slide through. Let me also put a point at the origin here. And this fixed point will give a distance from B, now we'll call that A. Now we have one line through A, and we have another line coming from B, segment coming from B, and with a slider at C, which lets it slide up and down this line through A. But this line here is going to be a specific length, and we can now put an angle here to drive the mechanism. So this is what's going to happen with that mechanism. Now, if we now create a line through C perpendicular to this line, then that is going to be the one which envelops the hyperbola. If we select the line to create the envelope, we select the point and then use the locus tool for an envelope. We select the line and then use the same tool. It's now going to be an envelope tool. And there we see it envelops this curve, which certainly looks like a hyperbola. Let's just watch it do its enveloping. However, let's check to make sure that it is actually hyperbola. We can look at this equation. Okay, so we see we've got an x squared and y squared. It's definitely the equation of a conic. An exercise we could do is, what's the equation of the asymptotes of that hyperbola? Well, let's have a look. If we imagine this to be the equation of a line, so we can ignore the constant kind of, and we're going to see that y squared equals x squared times b squared, when we say squared over b squared. So that's kind of like y equals the line y equals the square root of b squared minus a squared over b times x. So we can observe, see if that really is persuasive by drawing such a line. And let me show you how we would do that. We'll draw a line, the sketch of a line. And we can then constrain its equation. There's the equation constraint. So we now get to put in the equation of the line. What I want to do is put y equals, this is what I think is going to be the equation of the of one of the asymptotes, square root of b squared minus a squared. Divided by b. times x. B squared minus A squared. I think I wanted to make that A squared minus B squared. A is bigger than B. So let's do that. Y equals the square root of A squared minus square root of A squared minus B squared. Over B times X, and that one might zoom out to see it does indeed look like it might be the asymptote. We can observe that if we change our parameters, does seem to behave as an asymptote. Zooming out further, we can see that it is approached by the arms of the hyperbola.